Aaron Marie in the chat room wants to know, what inspired you to go into acting?
And what would you be doing if you weren't doing that? What else would you be doing?
That's a good question. I wanted to be a police officer like my dad for quite a while through high school. And then I did a play. I did Guys and Dolls. And I got like a little part in Guys and Dolls in high school. And then I got the bug. And then that was it. I started doing plays. And at around the same time, Jim Caviezel, who was in The Passion of the Christ, he is from the same hometown that I am from, Mount Vernon. And at the time, he had just booked Wyatt Earp with Kevin Costner. He had gotten the role as one of his brothers, and it was big news around town, and wow, it was, you know, in the paper. And I saw that, and I'm like, man, like, I think I could do that too. And so I continued doing plays, and I looked at the local newspaper, and I found an ad for an agency called Kid Biz in Seattle. And I went and auditioned, and they took me immediately, and then they set me up the next day for my first audition for a movie called Born to Be Wild. It was a Warner Brothers movie that had come up from L.A. to film, and I booked my first audition, which was two lines playing a burger boss. And that was it, man. And I was hooked. And I've been fortunate enough to work ever since. And what would I do if I wasn't an actor at this point? I think I'm going to go into paranormal investigating.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
That's fun.
Yeah. Yeah, why not, you know?
Woody watches all the paranormal investigating shows.
Yeah, Woody watches all those paranormal shows.
I think you'd be good at it.
Oh, man, I love it, man. I've had a lot of experiences over my life, and I'm very passionate about ghosts on the other side, and I get a real thrill out of that. And, I love Ghost Adventures. I watch it like crazy, man. I love that show.
Zach is great, huh?
So, yeah. I love that show.
I also like the fact that you were on Criminal Minds, because that's my favorite out of all the like police shows that you just did that recently, right? Has your episode aired?
No, I think it's going to air in, I don't know, a couple of weeks maybe, 2 or 3 weeks.
Yeah, make sure you tweet when it's going to air so we can see it, because like, I love that show.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely, I will. Mm-hmm.
I liked it better with Macy Patinkin, but it's a great show. Yeah, I love it.
And Sons of Anarchy was on there too.
Yeah, and you were in Sons of Anarchy.
No. I was. I had a little part in Sons, and I had never actually seen the show before. And, once I got cast, my girlfriend and I started watching it, and now it's like one of our favorite shows of all time. It's awesome.
Woody watches it religiously.
Yeah, it's a great show.
You also watch The Cape, too.
Yeah, I watched The Cape. The Cape is great.
You're in The Cape, too.
The Cape.
Yeah.
Yes, The Cape. The Cape was a fun experience. I got to do things I've never done before, shoot guns, get in the camouflage, you know. Unfortunately, you know, rest in peace, The Cape.
Died.
You know, it's one of those things, yeah. But I had a great experience with it and got to work with great people and got to be kind of a badass and a different kind of badass, I guess.
Yeah, normally you're getting shot.
That's funny. I die a lot.
Yes, but in like really cool ways, usually speaking, especially in I Spit.
Yeah, like I guess we can't tell people who haven't seen the movie, but like the way you get killed in I Spit on Your Grave is awesome, dude. When she's shoving the gun up that guy's ass.
totally, man. I was so nervous because it had these squibs on me, these exploding packs that were like bigger than I've ever seen in my life, in my whole career. And then it had like cannon, like basically right in front of me, filled with like goop and body parts and blood. And all that basically went off from the same time. And I was just like, I was shaking a little bit.
That's awesome, though.
Real life scary. Yeah.
Totally.
I think, too, like, going back to Spit, since we're on it, like, with the remake, I'm, like, a super huge fan of the original, and so always it's difficult for me to watch a remake when, like, I love the original so much. There was a different dimension in this movie, too, like, with the police officer being involved.
Yeah.
And, like, it just added, like, another layer of terror to me, and, like, we're like in the middle of the stuff where we actively know how corrupt our government is down here in Florida. It's like super corrupt. Right. And so that brought that back, like, you know, here you want to go and get some help. And then everybody's in on everything.
Yeah, I had a whole different, you know, dimension of terror because there's really no way out. She had no way out, you know what I mean? And Andrew Howard is a phenomenal actor. That guy is awesome. And he really brought, like, it's an amazing character. And, you know, we were just in awe of him. I mean, everything came out of his mouth was brilliant. It was he's a great one-liners he's got in that film, too.
Yeah. His accent and everything was really good, too.
I was thinking, like, it would be cool to do an I Spit on Your Grave show. Like, we did a Walking Dead show, and we had a bunch of the cast from The Walking Dead all call in at the same time.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, maybe we could
do you know
an
Michael
I Spit
Rooker?
On the Grave. Yeah, do you know Michael Rooker? We had Michael Rooker and
Adam Manaro.
Adam Manarovich. Anyway, we had a Walking Dead show, and it was awesome. And maybe I could hook us up. We could do an I Spit on Your Grave show. And,
that would be cool.
Because I'm following the director dude on Twitter, and it would be fun to get like four or five of you guys on at one time, and everybody get to talk about their experience. And that way we can promote the release of the movie.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Absolutely. I think they'd be down for that. I think they would definitely be down for that.
Yeah, it's cool.
Is the DVD out now, do you know?
Is the DVD already out?
Oh, yeah, it came out February 8th.
February 8th. I reckon it for we should promote it all, and that way we can get you guys, because you guys could totally bank, too, if you went to conventions as, like, an I Spit on Your Grave group.
Yeah. Absolutely.
You know, we all want to bank.
Right, of course.
Whoever Little McKay is, like, she knows a lot about your girlfriend. Do you know Little McKay? I don't know who Little McKay is.
Little McKay is Maddie, who did the editing for the Vampire Blogger.
Little McKay, you rule. Okay, she's awesome. We love you.
She's great. I love her. Yeah, Little McKay, I met on Twitter, like, I don't know, 2 years ago. She had made this. She's really talented. She made this video. Because there was this whole P. Diddy war, it was supernatural, and she made this great video, and I wrote her, I think you're really talented. And we just kept talking back and forth for quite some time, and then eventually I was like, you know, will you work with us? You know, and that's the beauty of Twitter, man. I mean, it really keeps you in contact, and you meet other artists and different people, and it's really great.
Yeah, and you can collaborate around the world. Like, the one thing about us is, you know, we're broadcasting in 150 countries. I mean, how cool is that? Like, you know,
absolutely.
Technology today. What do you think is the future for technology with filmmaking?
Wow. I think the future, who knows what the future is. I know now, you know, people can pretty much do it from their home. I mean, they can go out, get their software. You know, the internet really allows you to have a platform that, you know, even when I first came to Los Angeles, God, however many years ago, you know, I remember there was like one computer in the house I lived in. It was like, it looked like a dinosaur. You know, now you can do anything you want, and I can distribute my own videos. And, you know, with Twitter, I can get just about 1,000 views on some ridiculous, you know, follower speech that I made. You know, it just really opens up doors. And so I can only imagine what it's going to be like in 3-4 years from now.
Yeah,
absolutely. It's going to be cool as hell.
You know?
So what do you got coming up in the future? Are you got anything scheduled else that we need to know about or that you would like to promote?
What do I have coming up in the future? You know, I'm on the Universe of Good Humor at the moment. I just wrapped Criminal Minds. You know, I'm auditioning. A few other things in the hopper, but I don't think I can really disclose that just yet. But when it's confirmed, I will definitely let you guys know. So
yeah, that's cool.
About it. I think you're kidding.
Yeah, we would love to do that.
You'll get a big kick out of it. Yeah, I'll let you know. As soon as it's confirmed, I'll let you know, because I think you'll like it.
We want to help get Sven, though, on, like, its own thing. I really like the Sven idea.
It really warms my heart that you guys love Sven, and it just really pumps me up to try to make him, you know, like I said, have his own web series or, you know, have a show.
Auto-Tune the News, like, made it on the Oscars, and so, like, Sven should be on the Oscars next year. Totally. How awesome would that be?
He'd be a great interviewer. He'd be a great interviewer.
Oh yeah. God,
that would be so good.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah. It really would. Well, we think all the projects that you have done in the past, I mean, you've really had an awesome, incredible career. I also just think, like, you're just cool as shit, dude. Like, I mean, what a great guest you've been, and, like, how much fun we've had interacting over the past week, and we would love to continue to do so. And we want to promote everything we can, Chad Lindbergh, because you just fucking froke. Excuse me.
That's four strikes against you today.
You guys have been awesome. Thank you so much. It really warms my heart, and I mean that when you guys are, you know, supporting what I do, and I can't thank you enough.
Also, somebody in the chat room says, tell Chad Lindbergh to keep responding to his Twitter followers. It makes our day, with a smiley. I guess that's a smiley face.
That's awesome.
That's a tongue out.
Oh, that's a tongue out. Okay. I like the way you like respond on your Twitter too. I think it's super cool, and so we'll have to do some kind of something really big for the 20,000 followers. Hopefully, we can get that in the next week or two.
Well, maybe I'll do a speech on your show.
Yeah, there you go. We'll dig that. I'll help get the followers just so we can do it.
All right. That sounds good,
dude.
I'm all about it.
We want to thank you for coming on the show. We think you're awesome. We're gonna stay in touch. If you ever need anything, let us know. And any way we can help, we're all about it.
Thank you so much, and I will keep in touch, and I will let you know when something else comes up. And thank you for having me on your show. I really appreciate it.
Awesome, dude. Good luck with everything. Have a great weekend, and thanks for being on the Jimmy Star Show. And say goodbye in Sven.
This has been just an absolute, it's just so wonderful to talk to you guys. And I just want to thank all my followers out there for just being so special. And that's pretty much all I got to say.
Way to go, dude. You rock. Thanks so much. Have a great weekend.
Bye, Chad.
Bye, Chad.
And thank you so much.
All right, dude. Have a good one. Bye-bye. Bye, Chad. That was so awesome. Sven is awesome.
That was awesome.
That was so hilarious. He's so cool, you guys. What a cool guy.
He's gonna do very well.
He's like my new favorite
actor.
He
is doing very well.
Yeah. He's like my new favorite actor.
Mine too. He's so nice on Twitter.
No, I mean long term. He's just gonna be a great. Yeah.